Soon as you write your dream down, somebody about to bust you in your mouth. Whatever it is that thing you say you want to do, they coming at you.
Look, if you're not already onto this movement, man, you need to continue to find ways to get on this movement. ET said put yourself around new information, and that's exactly what we're doing. This is an investment. If it wasn't for my mom, I probably wouldn't even be here.
When you get your butt knocked out, the only way you can get back up is from the inside out. The inside out.
I want the world to know to and make an investment in your family and make an investment in your company. And don't fall short of that.
Live your full potential. How long are you gonna be average and satisfied? How long? He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. Now, a lot of young people talk about the Black Mamba. The Black Mamba, let me tell you something. When you talk about the Black Mamba, you talk about practice, it's a must-have. I watched this dude lose a game. I don't even know if it was the playoffs. I think it was like a regular game against the Miami Heat in Miami, South Beach, Florida. I don't know if you've ever been there before, but you want to go. It's a nice place to just hang out. Especially if you're on the road playing ball, it's a nice place after the game to go get dinner, sit on the beach. It's a nice, and I'm sure if you NBA, they probably got a VIP section for them on the beach. And unfortunately, the Lakers lost to the Miami Heat because Black Mamba missed a wide open shot in the corner, set shot, he missed it. And what he did for the next 3-4 hours while everybody else was getting dressed and going on the beach, he sat there for hours shooting the exact same shot over and over and over and over, like he had never won a championship. I'm like, now hold up, where everybody else at on the Lakers? They need to be out there as a squad. But the Black Mamba's out there doing his thing like, I'm not on them, I messed up, I gotta practice. And this is not a coach practice, this is not an the organization didn't call this one. This was just flat out. The Black Mamba was saying, this is a must have. And where most of you go wrong, you're not even 4.0 and you're not studying. Like, you're not even a 4.0 student. Like, you got a 2.0, a 2.5, a 3 something. And you still not really studying like that, because for you it's like, it's not a must have. It blows my mind. I work with professional athletes. I work with D1 athletes all over the world. And when I look at Twitter and Instagram, it blows my mind how dudes on Instagram, I'm like, bruh, you have not won a championship. Like, that's what you come here for, to win a championship. And so if you don't win a championship, I don't even know why it's people broke. I don't even know how you had enough time to do a 30-second video. You broke. How did you have time to do a video? How did you have time, like, to do a dance routine when you should be practicing? You should be lifting weights. You should be looking at film. You said, not me, that you want to win the tourney, that you want to win it all. You want to go to the Final Four. How do you want to go to the Final Four, but your schedule don't look like the Final Four? What are you tweeting about when you broke? You about to get kicked out on academic probation. What are you tweeting about? What are you talking about? Why do you even have friends? Like, why do you have friends? What do you need friends for? They're not helping you study. They trying to convince you to do stuff. Let me give me one second. Listen to me very closely. I'm not trying to disrespect your little friends, but if they your real friends and they not helping you to get this, what kind of friends are they? Who are they? If it's your homeboy and he don't know what your dreams and goals are, if it's your homegirl and she don't know what your dreams are, if they inviting you to parties, if they inviting you to the movies, but they ain't never invited you to study, what kind of friend are they really? Because all my friends, this is what we on. Now, this is the thing, this got it, and I want you to be real with me. We got one or two problems. Either you're a liar and what you wrote down you weren't really serious about, you just did it because it was cute, or you really wanted it, one of the two. And you gotta decide if this what you wrote down, if you really wanted it or not. You gotta decide when you say you wanna be on the dean's list. You gotta decide, do you really wanna be on the dean's list or not? Because if you really wanna be on the dean's list, if you get anything lower than a 3.5 on your test, then you won't have time to party. So your measure for partying is a 3.5. Once you hit the 3.5, you're like, bingo, I made my dream become a reality. We about to go celebrate. We about to go party. Why? Because partying is a celebration. Did you know that? Did you know that partying is a celebration? What you celebrating if you failing? What you celebrating if you broke? What are you celebrating? You putting stuff on the paper that you're not serious about, right? Take it off. Just be real and say, I don't really want this. I really would rather party. I want to be a professional partier. I don't really want this. I don't want to pay the price for this. Are you serious or not? Because I'm here to tell you something. Anything you want as a human being, you have the intelligence to do it. People in wheelchairs making stuff happen. It's the one dude, he ain't got no arms or legs. My man, a motivational speaker, murdering the game. And when he get the mic, he killing it. I'm competing against my man. I got all my extremities and my man been getting paid. You got your legs, your arms, you got parents helping you. You got programs, Michigan State University, and you ain't nowhere close to the stuff you wrote down. Arms, legs, you got everything, but heart. You got everything but heart. You got everything but discipline. Do you understand every night? Do you understand every night I want to hit cookies and ice cream every night? I'm just gonna be 100. Somebody else in here, you just on juice and stuff. You get like you on a whole nother level. I'm not on drinking juice all day. I want cookies and ice cream every single night. I want it, and I'm talking about the ones I warm up myself, not the ones I buy, the ones that you do 350 preheat and you get it. I'm serious. I ain't playing 350 preheat and you sit in the kitchen for 10, wait for the tea. And then I want to cut mine. They got the new ones where they're already in circles. I want to cut my own and put the aluminum foil down with the butter ministry on the aluminum foil. So she come right off. I don't even want none of my cookie to stick to the aluminum foil. I butter it up so all of it, boom. Then my son taught me right when you come up, bah, drop the hook up and they flatten, blah. And then put them back in for 2 minutes, right? With a scoop of ice cream, with milk, with the cookie on top, blend. I just want to do that every night, but I also don't want a gut. Every night, it's a test. Gut, cookie, cookie, gut. Every night, we like fighting, every night. And I listen to me very closely. I ain't strong, so I keep Pillsbury Dough on deck in the refrigerator. I keep them on deck. I refuse to feel like I want one and I gotta drive all the way to Walmart to get it. I'm like, if I lose, I lose, but we ready. I keep the Blue Bunny ice cream, homemade French vanilla on deck, right there sitting there. Every night I come home like, who gonna win? Every day when I get on the treadmill, I'm like, shoot, that I had to pay for that. That's 630 calories. That took me 42 minutes. I think I'm gonna have to go with that. I ain't hit it none this week. Cause I've been on the treadmill and it cost. And I need you to understand this. Listen to me very closely. Some of you are young and you may not get it. But you have to ask yourself the thing that you're doing and the setback you're gonna get as a result of what you're doing, is it worth the long-term dream and goal? Is it worth it? I need you to think that thing through. You get a DUI, is it worth it? I need you to think it through. Is it worth it? You get somebody pregnant or you get pregnant, is it worth it? Was it worth it? You got put on academic probation and you lost your scholarship, is it worth it? You slept in and didn't go to class and you missed that information, was it worth it to sleep in? Was the sleep that sweet? You just lost a couple dollars. You just missed an appointment. Is it that sweet? You just threw out, what is it, $28,000 to go here. So every class is probably about $400-$500. Like, for real, next time you miss class, ask somebody to borrow $400 and just throw it in the trash, because that's what you just did. You just threw $300-$400 in the trash every class you miss, because it costs. Every class costs. I just want you to ask yourself, is it the wants in your life that you indulge in, is it worth it?